Hey, what's going on? YST here, and welcome back to another raid video. Today we've got another non-unkillable team which can 2-key on Ultra Nightmare using Godseeker Aniri and Fahrakin The Fat. So if you stay tuned, I'm going to cover the gear, the masteries, and anything you need to know to make this composition work. So stay tuned and we'll get you that damage. Alright, so Godseeker Aniri. When I pulled this champion on the 2x Voids event, I was extremely happy once I read the kit. She's like a Sandlash Survivor 2.0. So let's get into her skills first. So she uses attacks one enemy, heals the ally with the lowest HP by 5% of their max HP, cannot heal this champion. This is great because when a champion is a bit compromised with their HP, her A1 is going to be doing great once she's doing counter attacks and the ally attacks. And then attacks all enemies, heal all allies by 15% of their max HP. So with Sandlash Survivor, she kind of just soaks up the damage with the ally protection. But with her, she keeps them up just above board to stay alive with the big slams, just in case a bad crit happens or you don't proc a Warmaster on a champion. But decreases the duration of all buffs on all enemies. This isn't the one that we really need, but increases the duration of all buffs on all allies is what makes this work. Revives a dead ally with 50% HP, then fills their turn meter by 50% and resets the cooldowns of all their skills. This isn't used a lot, but it's great for other content, but for the clan boss, towards the end when you're about to die, this can come in clutch and give you an extra million or two by reviving someone. But yeah, it's a great ability. And the passive, she increases the amount of healing on all allies by 10%, and if an ally is about to get killed by a fatal hit, preempts that hit and instantly places a revive on death. So if someone's about to die, she'll stop that, bring them back to life and keep your run going. Alright, so masteries, we've got the offense tree just to get the Warmaster procs and the extra hits, and we've got the defense tree to counter attack. Gear wise, we've got speed here, we've got speed here again, just trying to reach the optimal speeds. Accuracy we don't need, but speed again with a bit of crit rate. Crit damage on the gloves because she does hit extremely hard. For a defense based champion, of course we're scaling her defense really high, so she does have quite good multipliers. Defense percent on the chest plate and defense percent on the boots. So as you can see, all my speed has come just from substats. We don't need accuracy once again because she's not doing any debuffs. So HP here, defense here, and defense here. All glyphed up and optimized the best I could. 38,000 HP, 2,000 attack, not really needed. 4,100 defense. I do recommend above 3,800 to 4,000 if you can. If not, 3,500 is a good place to sit at. 177 on the speed, 56% crit rate. Reason for this, Fahrakin The Fat increases the crit rate on all our champions, so this will go up to an 86% chance with that buff. 200% crit damage, 110 resistance, and 157 accuracy. Alright, so let's get into the next champion. Fahrakin The Fat, welcome to the team. Alright, so with this champion, his skills. So attacks one enemy, 40% chance of placing a decreased defense. This is great for when Rhazin isn't proccing his abilities or if he gets like resisted or something, just to add a bit of extra utility. Attacks one enemy, 75% chance of placing a HP burn. This is great. And 2 5% poison debuffs. And granted, this isn't a consistent poison, but with all the utility it brings, it does kind of make up for it. Places a 30% increased crit rate and 30% increased crit damage buff on all allies except this champion for 3 turns, then all allies except this champion will attack one target enemy. So this is great for getting your giant slayers from Rhazin, your war masters from your other champions, and it boosts your damage up over time and it really does add up. And then this one here is kind of like a stalwart built into his kit. So he deflects 20% of all of his incoming damage onto all your allies. So he's never really compromised in a way where he's gonna die until the very later stages. Masteries. Offense tree here. I've just gone the cycle of violence just to try proc a bit of extra turns because he's not really speed tuned in a 4-3 ratio. So his ability where he's doing the ally attack is quite inconsistent and it just happens when it happens. And then the support tree, just to get the sniper and the master hexer for his debuffs, and cycle of magic only because I want him to proc more ally attacks whenever he can. And his artifacts, we've got a speed and HP percent, speed here, speed and defense percent, and then defense percent on the gloves, defense percent on the chest plate, and HP on the boots. I recommend this just because his HP and his defense aren't really extremely high, so the more you can get, the better. Get your speed from your substats and it will work out great. Accuracy to land the debuffs with some speed there. Defense here and defense here. And his overall stats is 42,000 HP, 4,000 defense, 2,399 attack. He has a based off attack, so you do want it a little bit high to get some damage. 173 speed, 35% crit rate, 151% crit damage, and a 298 accuracy. I recommend above 250 to land your debuffs, because they are very useful. And to get into the next champion. So, Sepulcher Sentinal, you've made it again. A1, decrease attack, brilliant. You want to book everything up here. Increase defense and block debuffs on all allies for 2 turns. This is what we use her for. So she's putting the block debuffs on all your allies, and then the Aniri Godseeker is extending it all to make it affinity friendly, so you're never going to get stunned and you're not going to get debuffed on the affinity clan bosses, and you also won't get poisoned. And then block the incoming damage on a champion, then 50% chance once booked to block all incoming damage when an ally is attacked, so it's good to keep your Skullcrusher alive so you can keep your run going. And then your defense aura, which is perfect. Masteries, we've got an offense and support tree here, once again for your snipers and your master hexer to land your decreased attack. The artifacts here, we've got a crit rate, we've got triple roll speed here, and we've got the accuracy set just to boost that accuracy up a bit higher. Speed on the boots to reach the 4-3 ratio, HP percent on the chest plate, defense on the gloves, accuracy here with some speed, defense and defense, just stacking the defense as much as you can. Overall stats here, we've got a 46,000 HP, because on Void she's going to be the stun target, but in this run today, unfortunately it's a magic affinity, so she's not going to be the stun target, but I'll get over that in a minute. Defense 3,800, 239 speed. Previously on another Unkillable video, I've showed it with 241 speed, but what I found is that some champions overlap into the later stages, so the 239 speed keeps it consistent. So if you do have it at 241, I recommend if you try replicate this, bring it down by 2 speed and it'll work perfect. 56% crit rate, and this obviously increases crit rate again with the Fahrakin The Fat. 100% crit damage and 300 accuracy, because we need that decreased attack always. Alright, so let's get into the next champion. Rhazin Scarhide. Alright, so we know what you do. Triple hit on the A1. Decrease defense and weaken to increase our Warmaster and Giant Slayer procs. And attacks all enemies, which doesn't proc on the clan boss anymore, so this ability is useless for this. We've got the offense tree here, and we've got the Giant Slayer at the bottom, and then the support tree just to get the Master Hexer at the end. Gear wise, we've got speed here, speed and crit rate, resistance and speed, crit damage on the gloves because he does hit extremely hard, defense percent with some speed, and HP percent here. Got accuracy on the banner, crit damage here, and defense here. Once again, he's a slow boy, so all these champions here are really slow, so they are very optimal to get to. 52,000 HP, 3,500 defense, 175 speed, 80% crit rate, 194% crit damage, which is quite a good number to be at, 243 accuracy, just to land his debuffs. Yeah, so let's get into the next champion. So the final piece of the puzzle here is Skullcrusher. I believe you can use any counter-attack champion here, it doesn't really matter. If you've got a Valkyrie, brilliant. But yeah, we know what he does. He's got the A1, we don't need the heal reduction, so no accuracy is needed on him. Ally protection and counter attack for 2 turns, so this gets extended once again with the Aniri. And then this one here is great, I'll show you why. So for Void, he's going to be the stun target on the first turn, and then he'll be able to take it off and it will be affinity friendly from the first stun. Masteries, offense tree and defense tree to get extra counter attacks here. And then we've got on the artifacts, we've got speed and crit rate, HP with some speed rolls here, and then we've got HP percent and speed again, defense on the boots, defense on the chest plate, defense on the gloves, so stacking defense as much as I can, HP because we don't need accuracy, crit damage, and defense again. And his total stats is 46,000 HP, 4,800 defense. I recommend at least 4,000 if you can to make it a 2 key, but 4,500 plus, perfect. 191 speed, so you need to sit here, 55% crit rate, 120% crit damage, and these, it doesn't really matter. So as you can see, the only champion here with a 4-3 ratio is Sepulcher Sentinal at 239, but everyone else is very slow. So slow speed, so you can stack your defense, stack your HP, keep the run going as much as possible. So yeah, and so it's going to be 173 on Fahrakin The Fat, this is very important. Then 175 on your Rhazin Scarhide, as you want him to go before your Fahrakin The Fat, so the decreased defense and weaken is up when he is doing the ally attacks. then you want 177 on Godseeker Aniri, and you want 191 on Skullcrusher, and you want 239 on your Sepulcher Sentinal. And make sure that all your champions are booked, so all the skills need to be booked on all these champions to make it work. They are all epic, so it's a bit more reasonable than a legendary booking up. So yeah, you need the cooldowns. And it's extremely important that Sepulcher Sentinel, Godseeker Aniri, and Skullcrusher are booked first before you do the other champions. But if you could do all of them, great. So let's get into a clan boss run and see what we can do. Alright, so unfortunately here it's a blue Affinity, which isn't a big deal as it is Affinity friendly, but Fahrakin The Fat will be getting a bit of weak hits, but it shouldn't be too much of a problem. But if you stay tuned to the end of the video, I'll show you damages for the Void clan boss, and I'll show you the overall 2 key damage, also on Void, and also this team works on Nightmare, so if you stay tuned to the end, I'll also show you that as well. So, let's get into it. So starting off here, we're going to put the increased defense. This is full auto on blue, but I'm just going to run through it anyway. Because this is blue Affinity, Skullcrusher usually gets targeted for the first stun because he loses the block debuffs on the first turn only. And then after that, it's Affinity friendly. So on Void, make sure you A1 with Skullcrusher till the first stun before you click auto. But on the blue Affinity, you can click auto straight away and it'll work without a problem. So let's get into it. So here, we're going to put the counterattack on Skullcrusher. And then we're just going to click auto from here. And that's it. You can just sit here, watch it, enjoy, and you will get a 2 key on Ultra Nightmare as long as you followed the guide. Then we've got the extension there. Ally attacks. And then this will keep up the whole time. After the first stun, you'll see exactly what I mean. Godseeker is also great compared to Sandlash Survivor because she's Void Affinity. It works out great so she doesn't get weak hits on these kind of abilities. Alright, so here is where Skullcrusher usually would have got the stun and he would have taken it off with his passive. But it's going on Fahrakin, which is fine because he's got the block debuffs anyway for blue. But let's carry this on. So I'm going to let you guys watch a bit of a run right now and you can see exactly where we can get this damage. And if you stay tuned to the end, I'll also show you the Nightmare damage and I'll show you the Void clan boss damage as well. So stay tuned. So as you can see here, Fahrakin The Fat did get weak hit, so he didn't do as great as he could have done. But we've got 8 million on Godseeker Aniri, 13 million on Rhazin Scarhide, Fahrakin The Fat with 6.9 million, 5.8 million on Skullcrusher, and 7 million on Sepulcher Sentinel. Yeah, as you can see that this team is a bit more optimal than the one that I've previously done. So if you don't have these champions, you can go back and check that one, which is a 2-3 key. But this one I'm finding a lot more consistent, and I haven't had less than a 2 key on around 8 to 10 runs that I've done so far. So here we've got... So this is the damage on Void Affinity where Sepulcher Sentinal was taking the stun, and we still managed to get a 2 key. So here's the 2 key damage. So I 2 keyed 72.27 million, so it was around 36 million a key. And after the run we just seen today, I tried it 6 times after and we still managed to get a 2 key territory damage every single time without fail. So it's very consistent. So here we have the nightmare damage where we've got a 65.57 million damage key, which is great. And the way to make this work is Skullcrusher and everyone needs to A1 after the first stun before clicking auto again. So you start with the auto after the first stun, A1 with everyone, and then click auto again. And you will occasionally get stunned, but this is the outcome that you can get. So yeah, that's nightmare damage. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure you smash the like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.